People always talk about Notion like, oh, it's this great document application. Yeah, it is. I mean, it's pretty good. But the thing is, it's not perfect. It's for that personal organization life, you know what I'm saying? But when I work with my business, do I really want sensitive documents stored there? No, no, I don't. It's not even a question. So I'm gonna compare Notion to Document 360, which is kindly sponsoring this video. Document 360 is a knowledge-based platform that's engineered for growing companies. For free, you can completely use it to have 50 articles, have a solid amount of drive storage space, and even have a fair amount of custom branding on there. So it's not like usable on the free plan. And on the startup version, costs $99 a month, but you get a lot more for it. And for startups, I mean, you need document storage, right? Am I crazy? And the key thing to understand here is it is private. I would not necessarily declare Notion to be private, and that's a pretty distinct difference there. So we go into our workspace at Rise Productive. What's really cool is that there's a nice homepage builder here, so you can have a little landing page with important stuff. So within here, I can store pretty private things like, for example, contracts. So for example, say I had a current client contract, client contract. Say for example, I wanted to make some standard operating procedures for some Rise Productive Notion templates. And there could be some sensitive information about things like logins and whatnot. I can drop that right in here. Now I'm gonna take some information here and this is gonna link to things like a YouTube video that's unlisted. And I can add another article here, which could be for things like Productive Brew, editing, and scheduling, which is a podcast of ours, to create. Then if I go here, do the same situation. I have multiple videos and some steps written out, as well as a more extensive article on overall podcast editing and scheduling. So I paste this in here. So then you can see how this is something that I don't really want to get around because I don't want people to know my process. So what I could do is I could categorize these even more into things like podcast. Another one could be templates, and then I could throw these guys in here. So then what we have here is a couple different articles that we can do some very nice things with. So for example, this is currently in draft status, but if I press in review, it'll change it to in review, and then people can go through and double check the grammar and whatnot. Then if you want to press publish, you can publish it and you can star things right there. You could add it, you can move it as well. You can press view in knowledge base and then you'll see it's right here. So sort of a documentation situation for companies that just makes much more sense than just organizing it in Notion. Now that did make it public, but you can also make it private as well. You can press security and lock it so that it's only private on the knowledge base site. You'll see here, if I press save and go back to an incognito tab, you'll see that I needed to log in with my specific company workspace to be able to see this article. And then you also have the ability to, if you want to, export it to PDF. So let's say we view it in knowledge base, print it like this and it'll export it as a PDF. And I like the layout of it. It has a nice video tutorial section because I put a header there. It has different things broken out based on what headers I put. And also this knowledge base allows you to scroll through the different articles that are in the knowledge base. Unlike with what Notion is, where like, I mean, it's cool in the sense that it can do a lot of document organization, but I actually would much prefer to work in something like this for like my process docs. This makes more sense. It's more broken out. It looks honestly a little bit more businessy, as dumb as that sounds. Then for example, if we go back to analytics, this would be a nice section to see info based on geography, performance, search, team accounts, and how different people worked through looking at the stuff in this software and with the articles that you put up. Something to point out that's really important here is the fact that you're not going to have this kind of analytics in Notion. This is just something that you're not going to get. And whether you want to see geography performance, generally how it's doing performance internally, externally, and you can even see that feedback at an article level, you're not going to get that with Notion. But I mean, if you're not looking for that next level of understanding for things like process docs or actual general public articles, I mean, yeah, you can go with Notion, totally fine. But personally, I think it's actually better to have a real drive sort of organization than housing something haphazardly in Notion for really sensitive information, because you really don't know whether somebody's going to get access to your Notion page. People in your company can share it pretty easily if you're using it in Notion. And it's not to knock it. Obviously, I'm a Notion fanboy. I'm a Notion consultant. But I mean, this is something that matters. You really can't back up things in Notion, in my opinion. It's not good. Like the backup tools in Notion don't export well. But backup here is pretty fine. Actually, better than fine. So like, for example, Document 360 automatically backs up your projects every day. However, you can perform them manually. So if I go to Settings, Backup and Restore, you'll see that it's doing system daily backups. And you can do restores of these different things like the homepage builder or the documentation. There are also integrations with things like Salesforce, which is kind of a big one, Freshdesk, which is kind of a big one, and Zendesk, which is kind of a big one. From a help desk perspective, Slack, Microsoft Teams, Zapier, Chrome, and Crowded. Notion definitely doesn't have a Salesforce integration, so this is really more of a business platform we're working with here. So sometimes I think it's lost that, I mean, it's lost on me often as a Notion fanboy that some documents should just be kept businessy. And the drive system that you're getting in here is really good. The ability to make articles is really good and have documentation for processes, because like this, obviously I have things like Google Drive, but I don't even know how secure Google Drive is as well, because of the way people share documents in my own company, in my day job, outside of my day job. And this definitely seems to be more of a robust solution for documents. I mean, it's called Document 360 for a reason. Document 360, thanks again for sponsoring this video, and check out this video on how to improve your productivity even more.